At age 18, Larry Alford was a top-ranked golfer playing with pros like Tiger Woods. He dreamed of pursuing championships and trophies, but that dream was shattered when an automobile accident nearly cost him his life and took his left arm.
And I made a bad choice. I skipped golf practice that Friday afternoon. Went on to drink, go party with some friends. Next thing you know, I'm in a Corvette. I'm drunk, going over 100 miles an hour on I-45, headed southbound. And I woke up a couple months later. And the car went flipping over 7 times, end over end. I was in a T-top, and I didn't have my seatbelt on. I flew out of the vet. My guardian angels had me land on a 5-yard piece of grass of median.
After spending over 3 months in the hospital, Larry's heartbeat had actually flatlined a few times, and he endured over 50 surgeries. Along with the physical pain, Larry also struggled with questioning God on why this had to happen to him.
I was one of the top 15 golfers in the world. I had just taken Tiger Woods to a playoff in California. That was really exciting. Then I had come the next few months, I had started winning tournaments because of that confidence. I had received a lot of golf scholarships.
Seeking self-worth after losing his arm, Larry began to drink heavily and fill his emptiness by seeking attention from women and alcohol.
When you lose an arm, you're not just, it's a social problem, but it's an emotional, mindful, spiritual problem. So I masked how I was handling the situation. What better way to do it than go get drunk? Go hang out with some women. You let your guard down. But in reality, it's tough waking up every morning with one arm.
With things of the world leaving Larry unfulfilled, he began to turn to the Lord.
I never stuck with Christ my walk through high school and college. As a more mature Christian and being obedient, because obedience brings blessings, I'm actually making the turn in my life.
Having a new perspective on life, Larry began to pray about getting back on the golf course. He found an answer with Muhlenberg Prosthetics.
I gripped a golf club and did an impression of my hand holding the golf club. Then I filled the hand and made it really strong and attached the child-sized knee to the inside and made it to where it would flex, and then attached a rotator.
Using a special silicone sleeve, Larry puts on the arm piece and secures it with a Velcro band. The design creates a perfect grip. After sliding in the club, the wrist joint rotates by using a baby's knee prosthesis turned upside down. Today, Larry travels sharing his story and message of faith. He also helps raise money for different charities by challenging golfers at tournaments, earning himself the nickname, the One-Arm Bandit.
I don't know why people call me that, but I just went with it. I entertain corporate and charity events across the world. It's actually thebandit.net if anybody's interested to see it. So I challenge you, Angela, right now to take me on the golf course. If you can't be a short, fat, one-arm guy, then maybe we need to start practicing a little bit more.
So Larry here calls himself the One-Arm Bandit because you've challenged over 2,500 different golf tournaments with, what, an average of 150 players. So I'm going to take his challenge on the greens, and we're doing this right now. For you,
right
Dr.
Now.
Robertson, and the entire CBN team. We set off to hit the links, and it definitely took us a few rounds to warm up, eventually ending up in a tie. As Larry continues to travel, he hopes his story can inspire others.
Is the pain in my brain and in my face every day and in my shoulder and in my hand and in my body? Yes, but everybody suffers one way or another. I feel I've been saved because all those people have been in accidents, who've lost a limb. I feel like God has put me in their life so I can encourage them that they can go on and they can do it.
Larry says, in order to overcome adversity, you must have faith and the right attitude. For more of his inspirational story, visit cbnnews.com, and there you can find a link to the One Arm Bandit's website. I'm Angela Zatopek, CBN News, Houston, Texas.